Look at that formation. That's all about team. Locked arms, Colin Klein, the leader of that team. I just like the way they do everything as a team, coming onto the field and taking the field.
It'll be picked up inside the five at the three by Thompson. Return goes over to the left side. Got a good return. So Thompson out across the 35 will be bumped out of bounds at about the 36. And our Jack in the Box drive chart. Possessions for the Wildcats in the first half.
Well, they really couldn't sustain any offense to start. They had the big play to Tremaine Thompson that answered the score by Iowa State, but then they started moving the ball, and I thought Klein really started making his reads a lot better in the read option, finding the holes a little bit more, and I thought that was the difference there as Kansas State took the lead in the second quarter. But Emmanuel Lamore, the senior, leading them with 8 tackles.
Hubert will get it on the first carry of the second half. And he is shut down by Washington, the safety, coming up from the outside immediately, maybe a half yard at the most. What usually comes into play with the Bill Snyder team, the Wildcats have non-offensive touchdowns. Now, they've got the ball right now, yep, but through the course of 60 minutes of play, there's only one team that has more, if you look back over the last 20 years in college football, and that is Frank Beamer's Virginia Tech Hokies.
Yep. So defensive touchdowns, special teams touchdowns, finding different ways to get the ball into the end zone.
And the numbers you saw since 99, but just further illustrates they make plays. Special teams, defense, Colin Klein weaving his way. Yeah, and it was trapped. And that's good pursuit, lateral pursuit down the line by Iowa State.
You know, last week, Colin Klein ran the ball 26 times against Texas. He gained 4 yards. And a lot of times he wasn't making good reads. I mean, he was just so beat up 2 weeks ago. And they had the bye week last week. And Bill Snyder really didn't know how the team was going to respond with such a late season bye week. I think they were a little slow to get started, but I think as this game goes on, I think they'll be a little sharper.
Well, they only had 121 yards as a team offensively last 2 weeks ago in that win. That was their lowest since 96. So their defense won that game. Now, Klein in trouble. Man scrambling out of bounds as he's tripped up across the 35. Latimer chased him down. He was pushed out of the pocket by big Jake McDonough.
That's a good job by that defensive front of Iowa State. And you know, Noxie said that, Paul Rhodes said, they got to play more physical, and that's what happened. They stopped them on the run the first 2 plays by being more physical at the line of scrimmage. They got after Colin Klein on 3rd down with just their front 4, and that's what you love to see, that front winning at the line of scrimmage.
Ryan Doerr sends out a beauty.
Beautiful.
It'll be Horn calling for the fair catch. Concentration was there at about the 20. Now the drive chart, our Jack in the Box possessions for Iowa State.
Well, they had big chunk plays, you know. They had the big touchdown catch by Darius Darks of 30 years off a little deception. They had the big run by Duran Hollis, his first carry of the day, changed field position. And there's the leaders. I mean, Woody, good tough first half for the backup running back, and Jake Knott, you know, probably not as active as he'd like to be.
Jared Barnett at quarterback. He was 7 of 12 for 81 yards in the first half. White gets the first carry and pushed around and dropped right at the original line. Garrett coming up the corner on that side.
See, now Garrett's one of the 22 seniors for Kansas State. And you could just, you just know, you go into the locker room at halftime, you take the lead late, you come out and like, we have to set the tempo. We're going to win our final game at home. We're not losing this game. That's the type of play you get from a senior defensive back.
It'll be 2nd and 10. A little more than 2 minutes gone in the third. White up the middle for 5. Adam Davis dragged him down. The defensive end out of Folkston, Georgia. So this is similar to what we saw early in the game.
White's limping.
Well, it was the shoulder.
Yeah.
It was dinged up.
Yeah, he's looking at
against
the
Oklahoma, but it's the lower half of his body this time.
Lower left leg.
Empty backfield. And let's see if Barnett tries to make a play of his own as they spread it out. Need 5 for the first down. Shallow cross is there, and a first down is there as well. Darius Reynolds, big yardage across the 40. He's out to the 43.
Take a look at Arthur Brown in the circle and what he does. I mean, he's going to get contacted right there. Bam. He takes on Albert Gary, and it opened up things underneath for Darius Reynolds. And I think if I'm right, that might be the first catch for Reynolds today.
It's not a pick play, though.
No, it's a rub. It's a rub, Joel. There's nothing illegal.
Right. Okay. From the 43, Woody's in the backfield.
Comes a corner blitz.
Malone showed him. And he's coming. Comes. Yep. And they're going right back at it. It's in the air. And it's loose. Will it be grabbed? And was it a pick? Guidry diving. Did the big guy get it? They'll look at it a few times.
Well, Guidry
right through the hands, though, of Darius Reynolds.
Well, Guidry's the senior. He already blocked an extra point today. Did he come down with the first turnover of the afternoon?
And did it get to the ground first? Yeah, Colin Klein wants to go in a hurry before there's a review.
Well, let's see.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's why.
That's why. And that's why we've got review.
The ruling on the field is an interception. The play is under further video review.
From the first look, was it a trap? Because it looked like it was close to a trap.
Well, it all got set up by a blitz of Malone. You can see that ball looks like it hits the turf. I mean, Guidry does a great job of kind of covering it up and looking like he got his hands underneath it, but that ball looks like it bounced right into his chest. Of course, the chest is so big, it kind of covers up the football, so.
But is it indisputable?
Well,
see, that's the key.
We have three good looks of it right now, and I think it is indisputable evidence that that ball was trapped, not caught cleanly. Interception will go back.
One more look. You be the judge this time.
Yeah, I don't know. It looks like he's got his hands underneath there, Joel, and the ball hits the ground. I think it's going to get overturned. All set up by a corner cat blitz from Nigel Malone that really forced that ball to be popped up in the air.
Looks like a very patient man, Randy Crystal, the referee, doesn't he?
Well, it's out of his hands. You know, he's just waiting for the call one way or the other, which is, you know, obviously the big difference between the college and the NFL rules, where, you know, they've got the upstairs replay official making the call for the referee.
Just looks like he has the demeanor that nothing will bother him.
Yeah.
Now the call from upstairs.
After further video review, the play stands as called.
There was no indisputable evidence, and that was what I was alluding to, because could you tell? So it is an interception by Guidry on Senior's Day.
Now the first turnover of the day. Came in today. Turnover margin was plus 11, second in the Big 12 to Oklahoma State.
That's second, or make it seventh best in the nation. They don't beat themselves.
25th takeaway of the year.
Hubert slugs it inside the 45, down to the 43. Got a feeling there's not going to be real pretty plays in the second half. We saw some passes go up top, but in a game, cold weather, moisture in the air, they may get a little tighter now.
Well, let me say this. You may not think they're pretty plays, but I think we're gonna hear the hits up here.
Well, I'm talking about razzle dazzle gadgets. So they have it in Iowa State territory to start a drive for the first time today. After the gain of four, it's Klein. I said to you while we were away at halftime, he's kind of like Slinky. Mm-hmm. Try to get a clean shot on him. It's tough.
Yep. Well, he's skilled. He's skilled at, you know, basically parrying the punch, just like a boxer in a ring doesn't take a full blow. It doesn't seem like he gets anybody, even Jake Knott, who leads this team in tackles, can get a clean shot on him. Even at 6'5", you think they'd take those rib shots and the shots to the body, but he sort of averts them, but most of them.
Third and two. Little delay. Hubert, he took the tackle with him. Taufoe thought he had him, the inside backer. And he just dragged him for about two or three more yards. First down by Hubert, down to the 34. And Hubert's not a big guy at 5'7", 185, a sophomore from Waco.
He seems to run with some power, though. He's got strong legs. One guy doesn't bring him down. It seems like he goes forward quite a bit at the end of the play. A lot of small backs can get knocked backwards, but not Hubert.
Run Smith in motion, trips up top now. Now will they go back that way? Ton of time for Colin Klein. And out of bounds. Dangerous Leonard Johnson there. Well, there's an upset already recorded today. The Houston Cougars up against Southern Mississippi. They lose, and they lose decisively, 49-28. So remember, you see the top 10. Kansas State is number 11 in the BCS poll. So with a win today, top 10.
Yeah, and that Conference USA, that's a shock. Southern Miss winning that game. Case Keenum, what a season he had.
From the 34, second and 10. And it's going to be a timeout.
He saw the play clock running down.
Little confusion, trying to get it done at the line. Come over to the sideline now. Key possession early in the second half for Colin Klein and K-State. A chilly, wet day, a gray day on Seniors Day in Manhattan, Kansas. Temperature right around 40 degrees, so you know it feels about 30 down in the field. Colin Klein on second and 10. Had to use a timeout. Now straight four-man rush. Bam. Wide of Thompson. Almost like it was an afterthought. And it's going to bring up a third and 10. Trying to get points, don't forget, off a turnover. Because this was all set up by the deflection and the interception by Rafael Guidry. So they started the drive in plus territory for the first time today at the Iowa State 47. Now it's third and 10 of the 34.
There's Kyle Klein. Colin Klein's brother, a freshman, who they say is a better athlete than his brother, taking a snap from center right now.
Third and 10, press coverage on the outside, and Klein running for it, won't get there. Dragged down. And an outstanding play by Rumpelhammer.
All day long, it's been excellent coverage in the secondary by Iowa State. You see, really just man-to-man situation. Really good fundamentals and good skills. You've seen Stevens or Reeves make a bunch of good plays today. Klein didn't like it, doesn't want to throw any interceptions or force the ball. Feel good with their kicking game, picked up an extra 5 yards and put him in good position to kick this field goal.
Now Cantelli, he's got a 36-yarder. This is going to be a 46, making a 47-yard attempt. And does he get it inside the upright? Yes. Points off the turnover. And a 7-point lead for K-State. Close ones, they're used to it. K-State, in fact, all 9 of their wins this year have come by 7 points or less. And early in the second half, the Wildcats lead it 20-13. Snow could be on the horizon as we welcome you back to Manhattan, Kansas. A 20-13 lead. And Kansas State now on top by 7 after they trailed early. They've got the last 14 points of this game. It's picked up by Horn. And Horn has a nice alley up the middle, making a miss across the 35, out close to the 36. Jim Knox, what's going on downstairs?
All right, Joel, over here on the Iowa State bench, it looked like James White, number 8, will be back on the playing field. He's okay. Take a look on what happened the last offensive series, running with the football. He went down hard, but took a shot in his left shin. Now he came to the sidelines. What they did is they put a thin plastic device around his left shin and taped it up very heavily. Still in a little pain, but still has a protective device on that left shin. So he's back in, guys.
All right, thank you. Hollis will get the first snap with Barnett this time. Van Barnett in trouble and on his way down. Boy, shooting the gap, Meshack Williams completely all over the quarterback. He couldn't respond. The junior from Sylvester, Georgia.
Well, I like Meshack Williams. Here he is standing up on the outside. And it changes the way you rush the passer. Comes in up the middle there. And very nice play. He leads this team with 6 sacks. That's a 7. guy that doesn't start, he's a playmaker.
Huge loss. 9 on the setback on the sack. Now Barnett, only his 5th career start, calling his own number. Gets a block up the middle, Arthur Brown. Chops him down at about the 35. And Arthur Brown, and you talked about while we were away, they've been so good on special teams for so long with Bill Snyder because Arthur Brown's out there and other starters like Trey Walker.
Well, both starting linebackers cover the kicks for them. So they're going to put their best tacklers on special teams, and that's why they consistently win the special teams battle week in, week out, year in, year out.
We are halfway through the third, but a key third down for Iowa State, trailing by 7. There goes Williams again. Now Barnett moving out of the pocket and right at the marker. Extra effort gets it. Darius Reynolds. He caught it at the 45-46. And once he spun out of the initial pop, he got the first down to the 48.
What's the matchup here, though, of Kelechi Osemele on the outside with Meshack Williams? Does a good job of burying him inside, allowing Barnett to get outside and throw that pass.
Garrett got Duran Hollis from behind. Did a good job not to cough it up because he didn't see the shot coming.
And here's the hurry up by Barnett.
Yep, tempo. Hollis again. And I don't know about the read. And it's an experience potentially because, boy, they crashed.
I thought he rushed
him. Yep, and Barnett had the whole right side available.
You know, so many. Well, look now. Hollis is getting up. He can't make it to the sideline.
It'll be a 3rd and 2 when they put it back into play, but you could tell
pain. Both running backs there for Iowa State in back-to-back series.
We saw Woody extensively in the first 15 minutes of play, and they were very efficient running the big man, almost like a fullback at 6'7", 235, Jeff Woody. He has not seen a lot of snaps lately. 7 carries, almost a 6-yard average for Woody. But a look back on what developed. Putting Hollis down.
Let's take a look at Duran Hollis. Wow. Got lifted right off the ground by Jordan Volker and driven into the ground. Yeah, he knows he's hurt. He's calling for the help right away. And Volker is a senior. You know, these guys, they're down to their final 30 minutes here in the second half of football at Bill Snyder Family Stadium. It's good to see Hollis go off under his own power. Gingerly. Amazing how quickly some of these young kids can respond and recover and get back out there.
So now 3rd and 2, a little less than 2. Woody joining Barnett in the backfield. Man, it's going to be Woody. Just powers his way inside the 40 down to the 39. So the tough between tackles need those yards.
Well, he runs with such a lean, a good forward lean. You could just see him carrying bodies with him. You get to 3rd and short, you got to put the ball in his hands. I kind of like the way Iowa State started this series, though, going hurry up, really speeding up the tempo. Caught Kansas State, I thought, a couple of times a little slow to get set.
Drive started at the Cyclone 36. Now a 1st down at the 39. Fake the jet. Barnett with the spin. And a good job outside of the tackle box. Just threw it away. Linesman's coming over, but I thought he was outside of the tackle box.
Well, that's another corner blitz that time by Malone. What they saw was once the motion had Jarvis West go across, he was free. And once West went across in motion, Malone came with the blitz. That's the 2nd time he's done it today, and they've gotten good results.
7 interceptions overall for Nigel Malone. Woody looking for a crease, never opened up. So a good decision of the previous snap by Barnett. We talk about the inexperience, some of the reads, but that was a great decision to throw the ball away. But he's the 3rd and long. Can they at least get some to get into field goal position?
Well, he's got great feet. You know, Barnett can keep a play alive, but the one guy that they've got to find is Darius Reynolds. I think he's the one guy that can win. He's down at the bottom right now. Look for him on a shallow cross.
It's 3rd and almost 9. Pocket holds up underneath. It's available. Man, it's down to the 25 for a first down for Gary, who's been the hot receiver over the last three plus games.
He's got good quickness. Got good quickness coming across the middle, and Barnett is spot on this throw. Impervious to the pressure on the third down.
Going tempo. It's Gary again. Wow. And what a move. A little jump cut as he shifted to the outside. Got about eight. You're so right. They caught Kansas State before they're even set.
And the key to this hurry up offense like this is execution. Can you keep picking up big chunk yardage like they did to Gary for 8 yards?
They get the offensive lineman off. And just in time as Woody charges his way inside the 15. He's got a first down to the 13-yard line. Dropped there by Childs and Lemur.
Well, so many teams in this Big 12 play this hurry up, up tempo offense. Iowa State right now using it to their advantage.
It's Woody again. Wow. And Woody breaks a tackle. He's gone. Touchdown, Iowa State.
That's the way to change momentum.
Well, they got him back into the game.
Yep.
And he was a factor and a force in the first 15 minutes of play.
Well, you can't argue with, you know, the way that James White and Hollis have run, but there's no question today that Woody has been a factor. And it's really the yards after contact that he's really started to gain. That last one, no more evidence.
13-yard touchdown run as Geyer is on the field for the equalizer. Snap is a good one. Bam. It is all even in Manhattan, Kansas. So the 11th-ranked Wildcats getting everything they want from the Cyclones of Iowa State with 4:25 to play in the third. 4-yard drive as things are all even once again in Manhattan, Kansas, and they went back to the Bulldog in the backfield, Jeff Woody.
Well, he delivered too. I mean, he runs right into the back of his own man, just gives him a shove out of the way, you know, and runs to pay dirt, and Paul Rhodes likes it. And I think this team really feeds off of his intensity up and down the sideline. He's loving it.
So the perfect fit, a guy that grew up just a few minutes away from Jack Trice Stadium at Iowa State.
Well, he told his kids when he got there, we're going to a bowl game and we're going to win. You know, in 3 straight years now, bowl game his first year, bounce back, chance to get to 7 wins here this year, and none bigger than the one 2 weeks ago.
They feed off his emotion. There's no doubt about that. Harper's back along with Thompson. Zach Geyer will get into it. And down the middle, it'll be Thompson from the 6. Again, a nice return, but just tripped up. Going out across the 25, Chase Hawley. Sensational play. Now, we talked about the Oklahoma State game earlier at Jack Trice. And what a night it was for Iowa State. They've had some upsets already this year. None bigger than taking care of the number 2 team of the nation at the time as they won it in double overtime. And you saw Woody in the middle of things again there.
Well, Barnett threw for 376 yards that night. Paul Rhodes' defense took the ball away 3 times from the Cowboys' offense and shocked college football that night 2 weeks ago.
Now Klein on a design roll on his way down. And will it be a horse collar? Yep. That was tough. The linebacker, Tyler Foley. And it's called by Randy Crystal, the referee.
He can't believe it.
Personal foul, horse collar. 15-yard penalty, first down.
So really it was Tyler Foley who just reached out and grabbed Colin Klein with one hand, but he caught, you know what that, well.
That's pretty tough.
It's pretty clubby. Yep. He did not get the hand inside.
No.
He didn't get it inside the shoulder pad is what they're trying to prevent.
He looked like he got him on the pad outside.
I think he grabbed the shirt, to be honest with you, and jerked him down, which would not be a horse collar.
That is not subject to review. Inside of 4 to play with the clock moving, and let's see how big a play that is. Klein calling his own number. Yeah, they read it perfectly. He is dropped by Neal. There were a number there, and that's the gang tackling we've seen from Iowa State, and they've been better. We talked about the resurgence over the last 4 games. The previous 7 games, they'd given up 222 yards on the ground. The last 4, it's down to 146 a contest, so that is significant.
Well, Colin Klein does it all, though. I mean, runs the offense, changes the plays. Mentally, he's into the game. Physically, he takes a pounding. He looks indefatigable. It doesn't look like he gets tired at all.
It's his call again. And he only gets about 3 yards. That takes them as a group, though, this late in the third to 113 yards rushing. And they feed off that because this is not a passing attack, as Jake Knott is in on the hit.
He is tough, man. I tell you what, I'm impressed watching him because Jake Knott's put a bunch of hits on him. Those hits in the middle, he's getting tattooed by three, four guys at a time and lining up on a key third down. Look for him to kind of scramble to extend any kind of a play here.
It'll be third and seven, shy of the 44. Or was it the right tackle? Jake Knott deflects it away. It was there. Sheldon Smith was the target. How about the timing of Jake Knott stretching out?
They're going to get another play here.
Defense number 48. It'll be a 5-yard penalty.
That's Latimer. And you'll see the tackle Offner come up as well. Almost simultaneous, it seemed.
Well, here's Latimer. He's going to get just an early start. He's in the neutral zone. Good call. It's a free play.
So now third.
There's Jake Knott. There he is in the passing lane. Spends a lot of hours in the film room just studying tendencies.
Yeah, Paul Roach told us he watches as much film as anybody on that team. Third and a couple. It's Colin Klein. Takes it, doesn't he?
He sure does.
And he still gets it. I mean, the shock absorbers on this young man.
Yes.
As he takes the jolt and still gets the extra yard down to the 48, brought by A.J. Klein. So there's Klein and Knott, and they combine for the most of the Big 12.
Well, and they're both, you know, the good news is they'll all be back next year as Iowa State continues to build this program. But when you bring that type of production back on defense, you bring a toughness to it. There's not lining up out there in the seam, trying to take away the seam route, then play himself back into the middle for the runs.
They've got a good thing going at Iowa State. Now on the throw, it may have been tipped at the line. I believe it was going for Chris Harper.
Yeah,
and was it Patrick Neal who got up there? Not a tall guy, but well timed.
Boy, they've done a great job. That Neal getting the hit, getting the tip on it. Yeah. Yeah, it looked like it changed the flight of that ball, and they have done a great job of defending Chris Harper.
So now second and 10. Zone read. Colin Klein makes a miss, breaks tackles. He's got 9 of the 10 he needed. Boy, what a spin. This is a 6'5 guy. He's not 6 feet. He's not low to the ground.
But he's always going forward. And Jake Knott has a chance to really bring him down in this play. Right in the hole. Just
overruns
makes a miss.
It.
Yeah, just overruns the play.
Third and less than a yard. Boy, this has been a tough drive. It started back at the K-State 26. Double penalties have helped it out. Hubert. Angles left, breaks the tackle. He'll get big yardage this time as he's driven out by Benton. So John Hubert, speaking of guys low to the ground at 5'7", 185, he broke all of LaDainian Tomlinson's records in high school football to the Waco area.
Yeah, Waco, Texas product, and you're going to see the middle linebacker, Taofo'o, jump over the pile, right? And Hubert ran right through the tackle. I mean, a great effort by Taofo'o. But then a counter great effort by the product from Waco, Hubert.
First and 10 of the 24. Big hole right side. Hubert to the 5. Takes the shot, but he's got a first and goal at the 3. The block was applied, but the fullback up front, Braden Wilson, helped out in a big way.
Braden Wilson is a huge fullback. 255, 260 pounds. He's going to be the lead blocker. Boom, a nice hit right on the middle linebacker. That's what freed Hubert up.
It'll be first and goal, trying to regain the lead in the final minute of the third. What a ball game.
Well, Colin Klein rushed for his 27th touchdown this season.
He's trying for it. And they shoot him down to the 2. He's got 26. He's got one earlier, and if you join us late, he's trying to tie the Big 12 record of 27 held by Ricky Williams, the former Texas Longhorn running back. The college football record by quarterbacks for rushing touchdowns, Ricky Dobbs, Naval Academy 2 years ago.
Okay.
And that's 27.
Not a lot of disguise on that play. Just take the snap and run right up the butt of your center.
Right, center guard. You better carry me.
Yeah.
What a third quarter, though. So you can see how much Paul Rhodes appreciated the work, and especially of his defensive unit, because it's been a short field after points off a takeaway. It's all even momentarily. Seniors Day in Manhattan, Kansas, and we get ready for the start of the fourth quarter. It's all tied at 20, our Sprint Unlimited update. And if you like gadget plays, you'll like our Unlimited update. Jeff Woody collaborating with Barnett. And what a play, though, by Darks on the jump ball.
You know, you get a chance to practice that, you know, maybe two, three times a week. And when you call game day, you love to be able to get it and score. Woody gets one of the scores for Iowa State. Colin Klein scoring his 26th touchdown running it this year. Woody just barreling over his own offensive tackle to get in the end zone to tie it up.
So the first snap of the final 15 minutes of regulation. Colin Klein with the call. Is it his call? Did work. He wanted it again inside of the two. It's going to be third and goal. O'Neal stuffed the play underneath. So those of you that are expecting to see Texas UCLA basketball in Southern California, we had a 90-minute delay for our kick because of severe weather conditions. And lightning strikes here in Manhattan, Kansas. Joel Myers, Brian Baldinger, alongside Jim Knox. You will get to that game, but this is a good one right now. Now, third and goal. And Klein slips. It's been slick all day. Klein's down at the two, where there's going to be fourth and goal. Now, does Bill Snyder gamble? No. Can't tell he's coming on the field.
But listen to this, Joe. I mean, this is three straight Colin Klein runs from the 3 yard line, and they didn't gain an inch. Now, he slipped on the turf. There's no question about it. But inside, the interior, McDonough, Woods, Rumpelhofer, all those guys up front did a great job of stopping Klein from getting in the end zone.
Fantelli, 2 for 2 with a 47-yarder, as well as a 36-yarder. This is a chip shot. Going to be a 19-yard attempt. Man, the lead once again for the seniors of the Wildcats on their home field. So a three-point ball game, just about 90 seconds into the fourth. K-State regains the advantage now, 23-20. It's a three-point lead after the Cantelli field goal, his third of the game, 23-20. Our Brown Hand Center, great hands, Big 12 plays of the year. Well, we look at two great champions. First, Brandon Whedon, Justin Blackman. Exceptional ones for Oklahoma State. And on the opposite side, the Sooners of Oklahoma, Landry Jones with Ryan Broyles, who, of course, was lost for the year, but put together a spectacular start before he went down. And don't forget, that's the matchup tonight. Bedlam Series. Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, and of course Kansas State. They want to share the title, so they are pulling big time. More than they have ever pulled for the Oklahoma Sooners, maybe in school history.
And that's not easy to do. To turn in that kind of loyalty, but it's necessary. These fans have braved some lousy weather, some lightning that struck earlier that delayed this game, and the spirit is here.
It'll be brought back by Aaron Horn from the 3 yard line. Looking for a lane, it never developed. So good coverage by Kansas State, and Ty Zimmerman making the stop on special teams.
Well, this is only a 3-point lead right now because of great goal line stand by Iowa State. Three straight shots from the 3 yard line. Colin Klein, I don't think he gained a foot on three straight runs. Slipped on the last one, but an excellent job. It's, well, who else would we expect to be leading the charge from the sideline but Paul Rhodes?
So opportunities in the red zone, getting away from K-State, and don't forget up the short field right before that. It'll be Woody Big guy goes low to about the 28, close to 5 on the carry. Now, is K-State going to pay? After the short field with the interception of Guidry, they started at the Iowa State 47, had to settle for a Cantelli 47-yard field goal. So the last two possessions, they had to settle for 6 instead of coming up with 14. 2 minutes gone by in the fourth. A lot of time left. And out of the wing, it's the running back, White. Matt, he's got it across the 30, out to the 31, shy of the first down by 2 as we check in with Jim Knox.
What an outstanding job this defensive line did on that last series, holding Colin Klein out of the end zone. Paul Rose came over there and said, told him, hey, guys, keep them inside. Continue to keep them inside. They did a good job keeping them inside, bottlenecked them in there.
All right, Knoxie, they did an exceptional job.
Look at that.
How close is this game? Well, 3 points on the scoreboard, yeah. You see, in total yards. Now, knee two, Woody, and it'll depend upon the spot. He's right at the marker. Who do they hand the ball to? Near side linesman had a better spot.
I don't think they're going to give it to him.
He needed to get to the just maybe inches shy of the 33. He's brought down by Trey Walker. Now, he's short.
I don't think they're even going to. Well,
they're bringing him in.
They will measure it.
But it looks like he's about a foot short, if that much.
You got to punt it, though. You
too early in the game.
Yeah, too much time left in the fourth quarter. Got to go play field position.
All 3 timeouts remain for Iowa State. Kansas State had to use one offensively 2 possessions ago when they took the ball away on the pick. Yeah. And they're going to be short, but
it's tempting.
And a half foot.
It's really tempting to go for it. I don't. You know, maybe Paul Rhodes thinks, you know what, we've got nothing to lose. We're on the road. We weren't supposed to be in this position. Maybe he gives it to some of those seniors up front. You know, Hayworth Hicks, the big, talented right guard. You know, maybe you cure a quarterback sneak right behind him, or Kelechi Asamoah.
Well, they're showing that they're going to go for it, whether they do or not.
True. They can wait it out.
And try to get him offside.
I wouldn't go out of the shotgun with it, though, if I was going to go for it.
And will it be a timeout call? Yes, Kansas State is used to second here in the second half. We will do the same just about 3 minutes into the fourth. It's a tight one in Manhattan.
As the first game was on a Hail Mary pass by Cousins to beat Wisconsin, knock them off the ranks of unbeaten.
Now, fourth and inches out of the timeout. Do they go for it? Yes, they do. It's Woody, and he's got it.
Yep.
He lost it, but he's down already, and he's got it across the 33. So the gamble pays off for Paul Rhodes. And we talked about Woody. He's a running back, but built like a fullback.
Well, he's the big bruiser, and that's what you want from that type of guy. Everybody needs a back that's 240 that can push the pile. What a nice luxury to have in a situation like that.
So 3 minutes into the fourth, trailing by 3. It'll be Woody. And it was almost a wrestling match. Arthur Brown came through, made the solo stop, but it was almost a wrestling match who's going to take the ball.
Yeah. But Arthur Brown didn't matter. He was going to tackle the mesh. Anybody that had the ball, he was on a blitz coming right forward. Just a good nose for the ball. Look at that. Avoids the center block right there on top of the back. What you expect from the captain and the leader of your defense.
Loss of about 3. Little pop out to the tight end. Man, chopped down was Hammerschmidt immediately. Nice open field play. Ty Zimmerman on the stop.
I tell you, the linebackers are playing so close to the line of scrimmage. You know, whether it is Brown or Lamore or Walker, they were hugging the line of scrimmage. The pass is the only thing that's going to loosen them up.
It'll be 3rd and 8.
They got some crowd support on this one.
Trying to make as much noise as possible. Spread the field. Barnett thought about running it, brings it back, and incomplete. He's lucky it wasn't picked off. It was tipped by Brown to begin with, and then Hartman had a shot at it as well.
They just squeezed him to the sideline, Joel. I mean, it's a great defensive effort all the way around. Great series by K-State. You're going to get Barnett out on the perimeter. That was an ill-advised throw. Look at Arthur Brown get his hand on that one.
Yes. And then it's a free after it's tipped. Yep. Anybody.
Well,
you don't have to worry about pass interference anymore.
Nope. And that's where Kansas State really flourishes. But they also flourish in this part of it, too. One of their fastest players back there returned this punt, Tremaine Thompson.
They need a big punt from Vanderkamp. They're faking it over to the left side. Can he get outside?
He needs help.
He needs eight. And he breaks the tackle for a first down. What a play by Kirby Vanderkamp. And what a gamble by Rhodes with so much time on the clock.
What a great call. And it was really the patience that Vanderkamp ran with. Because if he had rushed it, he wouldn't have made it. He was out on the outside looking to pick up some blocks. Unbelievable call. Now you get 2-on-2 on the outside. You get some good blocks.
Garrett thinks he has him.
Yeah. Oh, Garrett, the senior, missed a tackle in the open field.
Paul Rhodes, he's not emotionally charged at all. First and 10 for the 45. Boy, final game of the year, regular season for these two teams. Woody. Not much available. He squeezed the most out of that. 3 yards up to the 48.
Now think about it, Joel. Think about the guts it takes to make that call, the fake, you know, in the middle of the field. And what it does is you buy a second possession, an extra possession, and you keep it away from Kansas State. And the fact that they just got off the field, thought they were forcing a punt, and to get to keep the ball, that is an emotional lift for Iowa State.
Well, Barnett making the call to the line after the signal from the sideline. Quick out. Wow, what a grab behind him by Darius Reynolds. That was on him as he turned around and behind him. He pulled it off with Nigel Malone right next to him.
Wow, this had some hot mustard on it. I'm to the back shoulder, but Reynolds did a great job of knowing where the sticks are, getting both hands on it.
Catches the back end of the ball.
Yeah, he does.
Man.
Great catch, but really Barnett really fired that one.
First and 10 at the K-State 45. Starting back at Iowa State's 23.
This kid has a lot of poise to him, though. I like the way he plays the game.
He's got two to each side. Woody on a play fake. And he's, well, he wanted to scramble. He runs out of racing room, puts it on the ground, but it looked like Hicks was on top of it. He was the senior from Palmdale, California. Hayworth Hicks, right spot, right time for the Cyclones. But it seems like it's going that way on this drive.
Yeah. Just said that he plays the game with a lot of poise, then he lays the ball on the ground. But
that had to happen, department.
Well, he's just trying to fight for the extra. You see that a lot. Guys fighting for the extra yards. The ball gets away from them. And that's what happens when linemen get to the ball and follow the ball. They can pick up a loose one, a loose ball. The first one loose all day, and the senior right guard falls on it.
White's back of the game on the jet. A little play fake. Barnett tracked down Arthur Brown all over it. One of the very best in the Big 12. Arthur Brown coming up big.
Well, you live for these kind of days. You live for these kind of moments. And Arthur Brown, a number of big plays in the fourth quarter.
Unfortunately, an injured Wildcat down, so they stopped the clock. But Arthur Brown, a sideline to sideline guy, great reader. So he saw this develop. Watch him on the outside.
Yeah.
First, the jet tries to take him away.
Oh, that was great discipline.
Yep.
He doesn't bite, did he? No, he doesn't bite at all. And right there at the end. But you don't lead the team in tackles the way he does without being disciplined and square. Technically just sound. Oh, Guidry's had a great day.
Yes, blocked.
Oh, he had the interception, the blocked extra point. One of the 22 seniors for Kansas State. Really a valuable, valuable player and a leader.
He wants to get up. You can tell, and they're telling him, hold on, hold on. No hurry, no rush.
Looking at the left ankle.
Back to Arthur Brown, as you mentioned, and we spent time with him as we look back on the play.
And here he is.
He's engaged.
Fighting off the block and I can't look at that.
Yeah,
planted in the ground.
That's the only time we need to see that.
And that was Hicks on top of him. Mm. He's got the ankles taped. You know, I mean, they took all the precautions. You can see the ankles are spatted, the shoes are spatted. The last thing you want, though, senior year, final game, to be limping off the field like that. Just hope he's not hurt bad. And it's going to be a short recovery time.
So Guidry, senior from Texas City, Texas. But back to the gadget play, and we've seen a few. First touchdown, it was a flea flicker. Now, speaking of gadgets, the fake punt.
Well, Kirby Vanderkamp does a great job. Kansas State, they went to cover that punt. Now he's patient. Garrett's trying to get that tackle on him in the open field. He was patient, knew where the sticks were, and really kept that play alive. And here they are, third down again.
Can they keep the drive alive? Because this is third and long for him. The young man making only his fifth career start, Jared Barnett. Horn in motion and a flag, a free snap, offside, Kansas State. Barnett finally takes it upon himself and got the block from Horn downfield for an extra 5 or 6. To the 29 he goes. They can forget about the offside.
Well, you know, he saw the opening right away, though. He dropped back, wanted to throw it, but he saw that the defense just kind of split.
Offside defense, number 42. The penalties declined, the result of the play, first down.
You and I watched film yesterday of Barnett, and he made plays. But today, he's been a little bit tentative at time, taking it upon himself.
Yeah, but, you know, he has this freedom. And this is why he's in there. He's a playmaker. He saw it, and what a third down conversion that one was.
That was third, more than 12, almost 13. Inside of 8 to play.
We have a number of big plays in this drive by the Cyclones.
This one has taken so much time, though, you have to maximize points out of this possession. Still all three timeouts on the board. It's Woody. He's trying to find something. Man made the most of it again. Even when it looks like nothing's there, he gets three down to the 26. Brought down by Volker.
This is like so many games in the Big 12 this year, Joel. So many games into the fourth quarter, into overtime. Such balance. 8 teams going to a bowl game this year. A couple of Cyclone fans dressed in their coveted colors. They're holding their breath.
All 9 of K-State's wins have been decided by 7 points or less.
Wow.
So this is not a shot.
Not the new, huh?
From the 26, it's 2nd and 7. Barnett waiting for the block. Man, Arthur Brown got there. He had some help on the play. Also, Latui underneath. Kind of torpedo the situation on that side of the field.
Well, you know, this kid is from, Barnett is from Garland, Texas, just on the outside of Dallas. Father is a coach and been around the game a long time, and he makes good decisions with the football, and the game just gets bigger and bigger. Another third down, huge third down opportunity here for Barnett.
They've already taken 7 minutes on this drive. Third and about 6. Play clock down on Barnett. Gets it off with a 2nd left on the play clock.
It's a blitz.
And he throws it away. Well, they're in field goal territory already to even things up. So will it be? They won't gamble, right? A field goal unit comes on. And they've made a switch this year. Zach Geyer has taken over, and he's done an efficient job. UCLA and Texas coming up next. College basketball from Southern California. Now it's going to be, to tie things up, a 43-yard attempt. And the long this year for Zach Geyer, he's 8 of 11, 43 yards. So can he get him even? 6:17 to play. Exchange is a good one. On its way, does he hook it? Yes, he drew it beautifully. Geyer comes through in the clutch, a senior from Urbandale, Iowa. Pressure on.
What a game. What a game.
God, I wish my ball looked that good off the tee.
Yeah.
So it's all tied up at 23 with 6:12 left. And this is so fitting. The last Saturday of the regular season of the Big 12 this season. And it's going down to the wire. Left in regulation.
Those Brave fans stuck around during a lightning delay of 90 minutes. It's been raining start to finish, and they've been rewarded by one of the best games of the year that I've seen in this Big 12. And very reminiscent of just how tight this conference has been from top to bottom.
Now, Grant Mahoney, who they use for long placements, long field goal tries, is going to kick it off. Thompson and Harper are back deep. And down the middle, Tremaine Thompson from his own 13. What kind of field positions are going to be? He's got Harper out in front. It'll be solid. He's done at about the 33, maybe the 34. But how about that time-consuming drive by Iowa State? They got the three, but they gambled a couple of times to get
well,
there.
They get Woody on a fourth down, and they convert it there. And then they fake it on fourth down. And Vanderkamp, patient, behind his blockers, picks up over 10 yards and gets the first down on that throw. And then you get Reynolds diving for a first down. Then you get Barnett up the middle for 20-plus yards. Sets up this guy, a 43-yard tying field goal with 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Paul Rhodes likes what he sees.
Could be a different story, though, for Kansas State as they get the football back, because they had opportunities for touchdowns the last two times they had the football and had to settle for field goals. Now, boy, what a move by Hubert. Nifty running across the midfield stripe. Boy, great vision. Hubert behind the block of Freeze, the right guard, for big yardage on first down.
Well, the seniors up front, Colton Freeze and Clyde Offner, they open up the hole on that side. It's a little cutback. Look at that hole right behind Freeze, the right guard. Ooh, look at that finish hit by Leonard Johnson. We haven't called his name much today because they never throw towards Leonard Johnson.
So one snap after they get the ball back. Already K-State close to field goal territory, about 10, 15 yards away.
So, you know, Colin Klein looks over the sideline to see if he's going to change the play, and he doesn't. He leaves it on.
Going to be a deep play fake. He wanted the middle of the field. It's not available, and he's on his way down. It'll be a sack, a loss of about a yard. Back at the 45 in the arms of Jake Latimer. Senior from Fort Scott, Kansas, as the coaches say, plays hard every snap.
Now, what Colin Klein does is he looks to the sideline to get the play. He's in the huddle. He'll call the play to the troops. He'll then go up to the line of scrimmage, and he'll survey the defense. So will the coaches. Then he'll look over the sideline afterwards, after it's deployed, to see if he should change the play or not.
It'll be second and 11, inside of five and counting.
There he is. Now he looks over, not plays on, stays, it doesn't have to change it.
Pocket held up, first down as well. And the grab made for a first down. It is Terrell Miller, the sophomore from New Orleans, with his first grab of the game coming at an opportune time.
I like the size of these Kansas State receivers. This Terrell Miller, 6'2", about 210 pounds. First time they've thrown towards Leonard Johnson, number 23 for Iowa State, all day. And he makes a huge catch.
A little more than 4 minutes remaining, and already in field goal territory. Boy, deep single. Here's Hubert. He's going to get it. Man, he won't get out of the backfield. Big time play again as Ta'ofou gets to, and he's come up with some plays. Don't forget Connor Choops up next at the end of our contest. We could be here for a while with 4 minutes left. Only one time on the board, don't forget, for K-State, though. Mm-hmm. All three remaining for Iowa State.
Well, what Kansas State would love to do, this is the four-minute drill right now. Under 4 minutes to go, they'd love to run as much time off the clock as they can, continue to gain real estate, and then get the winning score, not give Iowa State any time with the ball.
Second and a dozen. It will be Hubert. Boy, Hubert's off to the races. Inside the 10. Does he get there? Yes! Touchdown, K-State!
And what a great read by Colin Klein that time on the read option. Really bringing the defense to him the whole time. He's really patient with this one. A good block on the outside by Thompson. Does not step out of bounds, dives inside the pylon. And wow, what a drive by Kansas State.
So the sophomore from Waco, John Hubert, has put Kansas State back on top. And now Cantelli with the point after. It is a 7-point Kansas State lead. So plenty of time left for Paul Rhodes and the Cyclones, but it didn't take long for the Wildcats to respond.
Biggest run of the day by Hubert, set up on the read option by Colin Klein, and strike up the band.
So John Hubert over the century mark on 15 carries.
A nice afternoon.
It's cold, believe me. Wind chill feels like it's about 30, 25 degrees. A lot of antifreeze in those young men. Now, going to be taken. Back penalty in his horn. No momentum at all, and he's going to bring it out. After bobbling it a bit, can't get to the outside. And he's ripped down before he can get to the 20. It was Randall Evans again. Second time he's come up with big plays on special teams. The significance of this game, if Kansas State can prevail and Oklahoma wins, it'll be a share of the conference title. Now, the tiebreaker belongs to Oklahoma if they do win, because they will have beaten both Kansas State and Oklahoma State. So they will get the BCS berth.
A lot on the line. And a lot. Bill Snyder, face mask. Sure. Never goes out of style.
Woody in the backfield from the 20. And Woody weaving his way for about 8.
Oh, he's been valuable today.
Well, when you have all 3 of your timeouts and 3 plus in college play, because it stops after first downs, that's a lot of time. Mm-hmm. They need 2 for the first down, and Woody gives them a lot more. He's pushed back, but he got it up close to the 35. So in the 5th career start, Jared Barnett gets ready for the drive of his young life. Now, can they get 7 points? Woody again. Cut off on the outside. Coming up on the edge was Tyson Hartman. Going low. Latui helped out as he pushed him back in.
Yeah, what I like from Barnett, though, is just the decision making. Getting the ball from the sidelines, getting the guys lined up. You don't see this type of poise from redshirt freshmen real often in this kind of conference.
Cyclones trying to pick up a 7th win. Trying to force overtime right now. Middle is Woody. And Woody's going to make the most of it. Boy, I don't know if he got the spot. He's going to be just short, I believe.
Yep. But they've got 3 timeouts. There's plenty of time. There's no reason to panic.
Woody needs about a yard. Look at him and Arthur Brown. What a collision. And Arthur Brown puts the shoulder down. I mean, he's not headhunting.
No.
It wasn't helmet to helmet.
No, it's just clean hit. But
right.
Good football play. But this Woody, tell you, some kind of endurance here. He's getting all these touches.
Well, and since they went back to him, they have been more efficient. Now James White comes in, who's more the home run threat at 5'8", 185, the sophomore from Dallas. On first down, Barnett running up the middle, making a miss up the middle, and close to another first down. He's got her to the 43. Poised by Barnett. They wanted a holding call, and a lot of us saw what was going on as they pushed. Wow. Number 95.
Yeah, Kibble.
Yep, was in the backfield, the senior from Houston, Ray Kibble.
Boy, this has been a good start to a drive. Really good start by Iowa State.
It's their first time out of the second half. Well, we talked about what happened earlier this year. Yeah, we were there for it. It was Nebraska. 8 turnovers helped. They took it 8 times. They took it away from Nebraska. The first one in his first season. Then Texas. First time they won down there over Texas. Iowa tripled overtime earlier this season on Fox. And then knocking off the number 2 team in the country, Oklahoma State, in double overtime.
I don't agree with this last time out, though. I thought they had Kansas State on their heels, and they were moving the ball. They got a chance to regroup, catch their breath.
It'll be second and a yard. Man, quickly to Gary, who drops the football.
Good read. Good read that time by Garrett, who's had a good game this afternoon on the perimeter. Read that that hit screen immediately, was right there.
Well, as you talk about that timeout, did he feel like he needed to regroup with his redshirt freshman in only his 5th career start?
I don't
Barnett.
Know. I mean, he looked like he was engineering everything just perfectly to that point.
Needs a yard with Woody in the backfield. On 3rd down. And Woody's got it with Brown on his back to the 39. 2 timeouts still up there. That'll stop the clock for the movement of the chains. And 1:34 to play. What a finish. for the Big 12 regular season. Ton of time over the middle off the fingertips of Horn. And it was there.
It was the right throw, and he just missed it. It was a great read by Barnett. A good route in front of the safety. And he cut it loose, and he just let him just off the fingertips by inches.
Second and 10. Woody leaves White to the backfield.
Aggressive throw by Barnett.
Again, a bullet, a low one. And below Reynolds behind him as well. Minute 19 to play, a third and 10 coming up.
Kansas State getting some new troops onto the field, trying to stay fresh, getting after Barnett. Let's see where this ball. Tell you, I think Reynolds had a shot for that. It was thrown low, which was the right throw in front of the safety. He had to get underneath that ball, though.
Need to get 10 over two snaps.
Got the people on their feet.
They wash out the offensive line. There goes the redshirt freshman, and it boils down to a fourth and two from the 31. And a timeout is going to be called by Paul Rhodes. So 22 seniors are playing for the final time at home for K-State. And they try to come up with a stop on fourth and two to preserve a win.
On that last run by Barnett, the right or the left tackle, Kelechi Omaselli, he runs out of his own shoes. There's a shoe on the ground. He wouldn't have been able to play in the next play if they'd gone right away. Runs right past the shoe. Barnett is just keeping these plays alive, using his athletic ability.
Levert,
kind of a dual threat.
And he gets the first down, if not a diving attempt by Emmanuel Levert, who was one of the leading tacklers of the first half. He is for the game. A senior from West Palm Beach. So it boils down to, for a redshirt freshman, Jared Barnett, he needs 2 yards.
That says it all.
Fourth and two from the 31.
Gotta believe Woody's gonna get the ball.
It's Woody, and he can't get out of the backfield. It's on the ground, it's alive.
Yes! Yes!
Doesn't make any difference. Kansas State has stopped Iowa State and will prevail. Again, Lemur in the middle of things.
They were ready. Kansas State was ready for the option. Great penetration. Great penetration against the right side of the offensive line of Iowa State. That play was made by the defensive line of Kansas State. Penetration will stop a good running game. And there's nothing that Woody could have done differently on that play with the penetration. He feels bad. Hanging his head.
Lemur was around his ankle as he got the football.
Yeah, I mean, he never had a chance. The penetration stopped that play from the beginning. Carter Bykoski. Barnett, great, great, valiant effort all the way around.
So now, just protect the football. Only one timeout up there for Iowa State. And K-State ready to celebrate at home. And I want to thank our producer, Bob Steinfeld, in the final minute as they use their final timeout. Our director, Phil Molica. Mark Allsmeyer is our technical manager. And Brian, I've enjoyed it. I wish we weren't having this conversation and we were working next week. It's been that good a season.
It's been a great fun. Great fun to everybody down in the truck. Working with you, Joel, it's been a lot of fun, and we couldn't have gone out on a better game. I mean, right down to the final minute with drama and suspense. The fans have been phenomenal. A great year in the Big 12. Phenomenal effort by Colin Klein. The fight by Iowa State. You couldn't ask for anything more.
One more snap for Colin Klein. Man, Kansas State, and they will pick up a 10th win. First time they've had a 10-win season since 2003. Bill Snyder has not lost his touch. They are one of the most disciplined teams you will ever see because they don't overwhelm you with speed, with talent.
No.
What they do is they don't beat themselves.
Well, they didn't beat themselves again tonight. And, you know, those players in that Kansas State sideline, they've got to feel great about the year that they had. They came out of nowhere. And who knows? Depends on what happened in Bedlam tonight. At Oklahoma State and Stillwater, they could have a share of this Big 12 title before it's over tonight.
No one would have predicted a 10-win season at the beginning of the year for the Kansas State Wildcats. Look at Paul Rhodes seeking out Colin Klein.
Yeah, well, you have to. What a great season. That's a great, great deal of sportsmanship between Paul Rhodes and Bill Snyder. Wishing each other luck going down the future and wishing each other luck in their bowl games.
So it boils down to Bedlam. K-State gets the win, just barely. All 10 of their wins have been by 7 or less this year. And now they wait to find out if they get a share of the conference title. Bedlam tonight, Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, and they need the Sooners to win. Let's head down to Jim Knox. Knoxy.
All right, thank you, Joe. Coach Snyder right now is talking to one of the Iowa State players, telling him a great game he had. Coach, let me get your thoughts real quick. Congratulations. 10 regular season wins. The last time that happened, 2003. You do it in dramatic fashion this afternoon, making a great defensive stand at the end.
Well, you know, that's 8 ball games that we have won by 7 or less points. And I'm 72 years old. This stuff can't go on. They're trying to get rid of me. I know that. Yes, they are. Well, I'm happy for them.
No. Talk about the offense today. Colin Klein, another terrific job. And Hubert, an outstanding game, getting the game winner. I think he finished 120 yards rushing.
Well, you know, I'm proud of Hugh. He does such a nice job. He runs so hard for a little bitty guy. You know, he's smaller than you are, and he keeps his feet going and runs. You know, he's a powerful young guy for being as tiny as he is.
Talk about tonight going on in Bedlam, Oklahoma against Oklahoma State. Oklahoma wins. You guys win a share of the conference championship. You big Sooner fan tonight, Coach?
Most certainly.
Okay. Well, congratulations. Another terrific season. Best of luck in the bowl game, Jim.
Thank you very much.
Joel.
All right, Jim, thank you. And that shot is what college football is all about.
And he does it with class. And you can tell by the way the players respect the fans. This was a great, great finish on both sides. Well-played game. But Bill Snyder, I don't care if he's 72, Joel. The things he does to win football games, it never goes out of style. And it never gets old. And he sells team. That's what it's about, and it's on display right now.
22 seniors go out on a very high note in Manhattan, Kansas.
What a season by Colin Klein. I love that shot. I love that shot, Joel. That's truly a love affair in a small college town here in Kansas.
Yeah, savor the moment, and that's what these young men are doing. They don't want it to end.
And there is no 10-2 team without that man, Bill Snyder. His decision to come back 3 years ago, the best decision to happen with this program.
So the surprise of the Big 12 continues to get it done. They win for a 10th time, and now a chance for a share of the Big 12 title. Coming up later tonight on Fox, don't forget, Big 10 championship game. Number 13, Michigan State taking on number 15, Wisconsin. Join Fox tonight, 8 o'clock Eastern, from Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis. For Brian Baldinger, Jim Knox, our entire Fox crew, I'm Joel Myers. Thanks for joining us all season long. Final again, K-State prevails by 7:30-23. You've been watching Big 12 College Football Saturday presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. So long, everybody.